The Golden State Warriors rose to greatness through the early 2010s with a strategy of building a team through the draft. The Warriors drafted Stephon Curry in 2009, Klay Thompson in 2011, and Draymond Green in 2012, which were the main pieces behind the Warriors' success for years to come. It only took a few years for these players to gain chemistry, and in 2015, they won their first NBA championship. The Warriors looked unbeatable that year, taking down the LeBron James-led Cleveland Cavaliers in 6 games to win the title. However, there were some skeptics of the Warriors' greatness, citing the fact that 2 of the 3 best Cavaliers players were injured throughout the series, with Kevin Love not playing a single game and Kyrie Irving only playing 1. Many people suspected the 2 teams would meet again further down the road, and to the joy of many NBA fans, the Warriors once again matched up against the Cleveland Cavaliers in the 2016 NBA Finals. The outcome of the series would have many effects for the basketball landscape. Would LeBron lose another NBA Finals and fall to 2 wins and 5 losses in finals appearances? Would Kyrie Irving prove to be a lethal competitor on the NBA's biggest stage? And would the Warriors win back-to-back NBA Finals and solidify their legacy as being the greatest NBA team of all time by both winning the NBA Finals and holding the best regular season record of all time, with 73 wins and only 9 losses? The 2016 NBA Finals started off very bad for the Cavaliers. In the first game, the Warriors were sharing the ball nicely throughout their team, with Sean Livingston being the team's leading scorer with 20 points, and the team shooting an overall 49% from the field. For the Cavaliers, they just couldn't keep up with the Warriors' offense, only hitting 38% of their shots. Despite Kyrie leading the Cavs with 26 points this game, it wasn't enough to stay with the Warriors, losing by 15 in a 104-89 point game. That next game was even worse for the Cavaliers. LeBron scored only 19 points, Kyrie only scored 10, and the team shot an abysmal 35% from the field. On the other hand, the Warriors couldn't miss, shooting 54% from the field. In this game, the Warriors were blowing out the Cavs so badly that Curry didn't even have to play 25 minutes, and the Cavaliers lost by 33 points. The next game was pretty much a must-win for the Cavaliers, and they were sure playing like it. Coming out with a dominant first quarter, outscoring the Warriors 33-16, it was looking like the Cavs could pull out the win. Kyrie had a dominant performance of 30 points and 8 assists, and LeBron with an even greater performance of 32 points, 11 rebounds, and 6 assists. It was the Cavaliers that came out with a dub in Game 3, this time blowing out the Warriors by 30 points. In the fourth game of the series, Steph Curry dominated the game, scoring 38 points and hitting 7 three-pointers. The Cavs couldn't keep up, and despite Kyrie leading the Cavaliers this game with 34 points and shooting 50% from the field, they lost and went down 3-1 in the NBA Finals, a deficit that no team had ever recovered from. In that fifth game, the Golden State Warriors had the home court advantage, but the Cavaliers ended up going sicko mode, with both Kyrie Irving and LeBron James scoring 41 points each, something that I don't think was ever done in the NBA Finals before. LeBron James shot an impressive 53%. However, it was Kyrie Irving who led the team in shooting efficiency with an outstanding 71% from the field, hitting 5 of 7 three-pointers as well. With those performances, the Cavaliers won the game by 15 points and brought the NBA Finals back to Cleveland for Game 6. In Game 6 at home, the Cavaliers were led by LeBron James, scoring 41 points once again, and LeBron's right-hand man Kyrie was right alongside him, ending the game with 23 points. Even though Curry had a good performance with 34 points and Klay Thompson with 25, the Warriors lost their second game in a row, this time by 14 points. It was now Game 7 of the NBA Finals, the biggest moment in any NBA player's career. With all of the media and hype surrounding the final game of the NBA playoffs, deciding who would reign as champion, there could be no more pressure than that single game. With all the added weight of the story behind this specific matchup, there was even more added pressure. For the Cavaliers, they would also have to play against a tough Golden State Warriors crowd. This game was close the entire time, With 4 minutes and 39 seconds left, Klay Thompson tied up the game at 89 points, and the next few shots from both teams failed to find their way in the basket. Everyone knows about LeBron James' famous block, and that if he didn't get it, the Warriors would be up 2 points with less than 2 minutes. But it was actually Kyrie who had the biggest moment of the night, as with less than 1 minute left in the game, Kyrie went ISO against Steph Curry and hit the go-ahead three-point shot. Then, with 15 seconds left on the clock, up by three, Kyrie Irving drove to the basket, getting in front of Klay Thompson, which forced Draymond Green to turn towards him, leaving the key more open for LeBron James. With the key being pretty open, LeBron James ran through it, caught Kyrie's pass, and got fouled by Draymond Green. LeBron then hit the dagger free throws, and the rest is history. Maybe you don't think Kyrie Irving was the main reason the Cavaliers won the 2016 NBA Finals. I think that's fair because I wouldn't entirely say that either. But I do think it's clear that without Kyrie Irving, the Cavaliers would not have won that series and came back from a 3-1 deficit. Kyrie had a few dominant performances throughout the series, leading his team in scoring a couple of times, scoring 41 points in a must-win game, and hitting the most important game of the series, and one of the most legendary shots in NBA history. Kyrie Irving's shot may have not destroyed the Golden State Warriors dynasty, as after the NBA Finals, they went and got Kevin Durant and won two more championships, but what Kyrie Irving did definitely had an impact in lessening the greatness and legacy of their dynasty. If the Warriors won the 2016 NBA Finals, then they would have been the only team in NBA history, other than the Boston Celtics in the 1960s, to win four straight NBA championships. This would have been a legendary accomplishment, beating Michael Jordan's record of three straight championships with the Bulls and the numerous Los Angeles Lakers dynasties that had three straight NBA championships as well. If Kyrie Irving did not help the Cavaliers win the series, then LeBron James' finals record would be 3 wins and 7 losses, and it would also give Steph Curry a 4-1 NBA Finals record, with more championships than LeBron James. Do you think Kyrie Irving's impact on the 2016 NBA Finals was as much as I think it was? Did Kyrie Irving really hurt the Warriors' legacy that much? Let me know what you think in the comments section, and remember to like this video and subscribe to the channel to show your support. Thanks for watching.